Hello everyone, my name is Banu Saraf and I'm an intern at UB Advocate. Today in this video we'll talk about the five writs of the Indian Constitution. For example, आपके पास एक private property है but उस property पे आपके पास कोई rights नहीं है, मतलब अगर आपको कुछ कोई fencing वगैरह लगवानी हो या कोई trespass आप करके आपकी property के अंदर आ जाए तो आपके पास कोई right नहीं है उसे बाहर निकालने का, तो क्या ऐसे time पे आप सच्ची में अपनी property को enjoy कर पाएंगे? नहीं, मतलब ये चीज तो जाहिर सी है। तो यही कंसेप्ट है हमारे जो राइट्स हैं इसका, हमारी इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में जो फंडामेंटल राइट्स हमारी हमारे सिटीजन्स को हमारी कंट्री में मिले हुए हैं, इन सबको सेफ गार्ड करने के लिए ही राइट्स इश्यू करी जाती हैं। मेनली हमारे कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में फंडामेंटल राइट्स को सेफ गार्ड करने के लिए फोर आर्टिकल्स में बात की गई है। द फर्स्ट वन इज आर्टिकल 13 विच टॉक्स अबाउट द जुडिशियल रिव्यू। The second one is Article 359, which talks about emergency. Whenever there is a situation where the emergency is applied, at that time the fundamental rights of citizens of the India are curtailed. The third one is Article 32, which gives the right to the citizen to reach out to the Supreme Court directly. Whenever there's an exploitation of their fundamental right, and there's a power with Supreme Court to issue writs under this article only. According to Article 226 of the Indian Constitution, the High Court also has the same power to issue writs whenever a fundamental right has been violated or anything related to administrative tribunals and etc. Part 3 of the Indian Constitution talks about the fundamental rights that are mentioned under the Indian Constitution, which tells us that Article 32 also comes under the section of fundamental right. The Supreme Court has been called the protector and the guarantor of the fundamental rights because it's only under the jurisdiction of the Supreme Court and also the High Court to issue writs when a specific fundamental right has been violated of a citizen. Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar has also said Article 32 that it is the heart and soul of the Indian Constitution. There is a slight of difference between Article 32 and 226. It is not necessary that we have to first go to the High Court and then to the Supreme Court. If there is a violation of a fundamental right of a citizen of India, he can directly go to the Supreme Court under Article 32 of the Indian Constitution. The second difference is that Supreme Court can only issue writs when there is an exploitation of a fundamental right of a citizen, whereas under Article 226 of the Indian Constitution, the High Court has the jurisdiction to issue writs not only for the exploitation of the fundamental rights, but if there's a problem with administrative tribunals or anything, writs can be issued under this section. Now we'll talk about the five writs of the Indian Constitution. The very first one is the writ of habeas corpus, which is the most powerful and the most useful one. The writ of the habeas corpus means that to have a body, if there is a person who has been illegally detained by the state, the relatives of the person or the friend of the person or the person himself can file a writ petition for his or her release into the Supreme Court or the High Court. In case of Rudul Shah versus the state of Bihar, the person committed a crime and was detained for like 14 years and was wrongfully detained for another 14 years when he completed the sentence that he was given. In this case, the writ of habeas corpus helped the person for his release because he was wrongfully detained by the court. The next. There are some conditions where the writ of habeas corpus can't be used. First, the writ of habeas corpus cannot be used where the detention is lawful, where there is a contempt of court, where there is a detention that is outside, and when the detention has been done by a court of competent jurisdiction. The second writ is the writ of mandamus. The writ of mandamus means we command. It basically means to ask any public officer to perform his public duty. So, हमें केस के साथ इसको पढ़ेंगे. In the case of Gujarat State Financial Corporation versus the Lotus Hotel. Lotus Hotel Gujarat State Financial Corporation के पास गए थे कि उन्हें एक कंस्ट्रक्शन बनानी है, हमारे उनको अपना एक होटल बनाना है. और गुजरात स्टेट फाइनेंशियल कॉरपोरेशन ने प्रॉमिस करा था कि वो फंड्स एलोकेट करेंगे होटल बनाने के लिए, बट जब कंस्ट्रक्शन की टाइम आई थी तो गुजरात स्टेट फाइनेंशियल कॉरपोरेशन ने फंड्स नहीं दिए थे. तो अकॉर्डिंग टू द रेट ऑफ मैंडमस द कोर्ट आज द पब्लिक ऑफिस टू परफॉर्म द पब्लिक ड्यूटी एंड देयरफॉर द फंड वाज एलोकेटेड टू द लोटस होटल्स फॉर creating their hotel. The third writ was the writ of certiorari, which means to be certified. It tells that the Supreme Court and the High Court can ask for review of the decisions of the subordinate court to make sure that the judgment is not illegal. And by illegal, it means that it should not be according to the excess of the jurisdiction, or it should not lack the jurisdiction of the court. Or the jurisdiction should not be unconstitutional, and it should also follow the principle of natural justice. If the judgments are found to be illegal, then it gets quashed. According to the case of Gullapalli Nageshwar Rao versus APSRTC and AK Kripup versus Union of India, the writ of certiorari was used, and both the cases were quashed on the grounds of illegal jurisdiction. The fourth writ is the writ of prohibition. इस writ को समझने के लिए हमें prohibition writ और certiorari writ को एक साथ पढ़ना होगा. जैसे certiorari writ में है कि मतलब अगर किसी subordinate court में एक judgment pass कर दिया है जो कि illegal है या जो कि गलत है, तो उस चीज को क्योर करने के लिए द हाई कोर्ट और द सुप्रीम कोर्ट कैन क्वॉश द जजमेंट एंड कैन प्रोड्यूस देयर ओन जजमेंट. वेयर एज अंडर दिस रेट ऑफ प्रोहिबिशन, इट मीन्स व्हेन अ कोर्ट केस इज अंडर प्रोसीडिंग एंड द डिसीजन एंड द जजमेंट ऑफ द केस हैज नॉट बीन अनाउंस्ड. At that time, if the higher court or the supreme court sees that the subordinate court is not legally under the jurisdiction to announce the judgment, at that time the writ of prohibition can be used. Like when the only difference between prohibition and certiorari is that certiorari writ is used when an order has been passed and judgment has been passed, whereas the writ of prohibition is used when a court case is under proceeding and judgment is not clear. The last writ we'll talk about today is the quo warranto, which means by what authority. लाइक सपोज जब भी हम किसी एक एडमिशन हम एक कॉलेज में एडमिशन करने के लिए जाते हैं, तो एक हमें एक एंट्रेंस एग्जाम देना होता है. एंड सपोज हमने वो एंट्रेंस एग्जाम दिया एंड हम उस एंट्रेंस एग्जाम में पास नहीं होते, तो हम उस वजह से हम पास नहीं हुए, इसलिए हमारा एडमिशन नहीं हुआ. द सेम थिंग इज विद दिस रेट. It asks the public office to tell like what authority do they have, like by under what authority are they holding that public office.